Hello everyone. Now we are going to perform the foundry operation using a split piece pattern. As we know, what is pattern is like it's a replica of the original. So what are the arrangements we have to make before going for the foundry operation? That was we have to place a drag, and this is a cope and foundry sand, as we are using a green sand, and we have mixed the water to maintain the correct water moisture content. The proper water moisture content has been maintained, and these are all the tools which we are using to perform the foundry operation. This is called as a single piece pattern, as we are not doing it right now. We are using a split piece pattern to complete the forging operation. As we can see, this is a split piece. So one half, that is half of the pattern will be coming in a drag, and half of the another pattern it will be coming in a cope. So this is a rammer brush, and we are using a wooden mallet. This is called as a trowel and flattener, and this is another a rammer, and the trowel of small size, where it is having both heart as well as the rectangular shape. And these are all the tools which we'll be using to perform the foundry operation. The very first thing is, first we have to place the sand in a drag, and we are going to ram it according to our requirement. Reverse the drag tool and place your pattern like this. So one split pattern like this, and pour the sand. It is called as a parting sand before you put the green sand on it. Now we are putting a green sand on the pattern. The required amount of sand it is poured. Now we are using a round rammer to ram it. And we are using a pin rammer to ram at the edges. Now with the help of the trowel, so we have to do it like this. So that the sand is poured layer by layer. Now further we are using a leveler to remove the excess amount of the sand after ramming it. As we can see, the drag is placed in a reverse direction because the single piece pattern, the one half of the split pattern, it is placed at the bottom. And once the leveling operation is completed, then we are going to reverse it. Now we can see what is the purpose of using a brush. We are going to remove the excess amount of sand which is fall beside the drag. It should be cleaned. Now we have to reverse the drag. As we can see, the one half of the split pattern, it is placed in a drag. Now it has been come to the top position. Now with the help of a brush, just clean it. Now place the cope on the drag and lock it so that it will not move from its initial position. We are using a locker for this. We have to lock on the both the sides. As we can see, there is a lock on another side. Now other half of split pattern, it is placed exactly on the pattern which is there in a drag. As you can see how we are placing it. So other half of split pattern, it is coming in cope. Now we are going to pour the sand on it. Now immediately after placing a half split pattern, the riser tool has been placed on the pattern. As we can see, we are placing a riser tool and we are pouring a sand on it. The purpose of creating riser is like the excess amount of molten metal, it will be coming through the riser. And we are going to place the runner here. As we know, the purpose of runner is to pour the molten metal and we are going to put the sand on it. As we can see, after setting the riser and runner tool, then pour the sand, then using a rammer, we are going to ram it. Use a pin rammer to ram on the sides so that we can see, and use a round rammer to ram exactly at the center of the parts. Now pour the sand to fill the cup. Fill the sand for every corner. Then later on we can ram it. Now we are ramming after once we fill the sand to the cup. You can see we are using a round rammer here to ram at the center of the cup, as well as we are going to use the pin rammer to ram at the side edges. Now use the leveler to remove the excess amount of sand on the cup. As we are seeing, we are using a leveler. As we can see, after leveling it, how your cup it is going to look like. Now we have to remove the riser and runner tool. So we are using a mallet. So we use a wooden mallet slowly to remove the riser and runner tool. Now see, we can remove it. And we have to give the smooth surface finishing with the help of the trowel. So where we can see the runner. And with the same technique, use a wooden mallet to remove the riser. Then once after removing the riser tool, we are using a trowel to give the smooth surface finishing. As we can see, this is a riser. As we have to make something like a cone type, so that once if you are pouring the molten metal to it, so it will become very easy to flow inside the core part. Remove the lock of cope and rod, which is at the both the side. Now separate the cope and rag after removing the lock. Now we can see one half. As we can see, this is a cope part. This is a riser and this is a runner. Now we have to remove the half split pattern which is there in a drag, and we have to create a gate in the drag. So where we can see, so this is a position of the place where we have to create a gate. So gate is nothing but it allows your molten metal to flow through the core part. We are using a gate cutter tool to create a gate. As we can see how we are going to create a gate. So as once the molten metal it is which is flowing through the runner, with the help of the gate it fills this part, the core part. So this completes your forging sorry foundry operation using a split pattern. Now let us continue with the scooping. The scooping, in the sense, we have to make the pattern shape as per the given dimension by the hand. Now we are preparing for the scooping experiment. One is, like, we have to fill the sand in a drag, the ram it properly with the help of the rammer, as well as pin rammer, round rammer, etc. Then we have to make a mark like this in a cross section, as the dimension is given by 50 by 50, 50 mm by 50, and the depth is of 2 cm, that is 20 mm. So this is nothing but the scooping. Now, as we can see, for the scooping we have done a mark like this, and we are going to use a small trowel to remove the sand. Now we can see how we are using a small trowel to remove the excess sand to create a shape, as the scooping has to be done by 50 by 50 square shape, and the depth is of 2 cm, that is 20 mm. Now what we can see, by using various tools we have completed the scooping operations, as the dimension it was given by 50 by 50 and the depth is of 20 mm. So this completes your foundry operation of scooping.